back. It's still Dakpo and Ishoma on CrossFire, and we'll be talking about our great country, Nigeria. Yesterday, Nigeria marks the 55th independence celebration, and it's been a lot of argument and different thoughts and different songs for different folks. And believe you me, a lot of us believe it is worth celebrating, while some other people believe there's nothing to celebrate. But what exactly is your position? You want to call us on CrossFire and let us know exactly what you feel. We have Kehinde calling from Mina. Kehinde, good morning.
Hello.
Hello, Kehinde. Hello, Kehinde.
Hello, I can hear you.
Yeah, we can hear you, but it's really very faint. Can you speak up, please?
Hello. Can you hear me now?
Yes, we can hear you.
Good morning. Happy Independence Day celebrations.
Hello, Kehinde.
I'm from Mina.
Yeah, please go ahead. Yes, go ahead and talk to us.
Okay, this morning I'm always quietly.
No, we won't be able to take that call.
Please call us back.
We could hardly hear what you're saying. Kindly call us back, Andy. And thanks for waiting on the line when we went on the break. Now,
can I respond to all the things?
No, let me give you more. Now, okay. He said something like, change does not just happen. You and I and all of us must appreciate that we are all, that we all have a part to play if we want to bring change, you know, that we've been talking about. He said, impatience is not a value. Order is more than speed. It's more vital than speed. Careful and deliberate decisions after consultations get far better results. And better results for our country is what the APC government want as change, and that is what change is all about. Now, Ishoma, let me make this statement and then you can come up with your contribution. I believe all these words were reactive. The president just simply is reacting to what the nation is saying, what people are saying, pocket of issues, organizations, statement made by vital organs of the Nigerian nation, made by public office holders, made by the opposition party. Now, these are some of the things, you know, that has been going on, and many of this information are in the public domain. And so the president picked all these elements and reacted to it. Obviously, these statements that he made yesterday were drafted by an individual. All he did was probably proofread and then read out on the, you know,
proofread
on the independent.
And it did add his own.
Oh,
just
okay.
So you
maybe.
Know.
Maybe.
Just so you know. So can I respond now?
Yeah.
We have a call. Let's take Elekwa's call. Good morning, Elekwa.
We lost that call, so go ahead.
Now, like the former president said, that all hands must be on deck. Beautiful, and I completely agree with, and that's my position. Yes, the nation may have failed us, previous administrations may have failed us, but the first things first, this is a new dispensation. This is a new government that has come out to say, we will do our own part. We will show Nigerians a difference from what all other administrations have been giving out to Nigerians. That is beautiful. But the first thing, we need to get things right ourselves. You talked about the public schools. Yeah. Do you know that some of these teachers in the public schools, they have contributed immensely to the decay in the public sector? They go to school and they don't teach. You see them, you know, shelling legacy. You see them sending the children on errands.
Yeah.
What kind of legacy is it that you want them now to impact when they themselves are corrupt individuals?
Is it their
they
fault?
Get paid.
Is
they,
it their fault?
No, it's also their fault.
How?
It's also their fault.
The government has not put structures in place. The government has not put structures in place.
There is a curriculum which they should abide by. They should teach the children when they come to work every day. But they do not do that.
Okay. Let's take this call.
Come
you
on.
Continue. Elekwa, good morning. Hello, Elekwa.
Yeah, I can hear you. Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, can you please speak up a little bit?
Yes, I've done that right away.
Okay, maybe we can add a little more volume from our studio too. But let's take your contribution.
Okay, I want to speak on the NLC statement.
We cannot hear you.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah, concerning the NLC statement, about the
Nigerian
independence anniversary.
Yeah.
They have a right to their opinion, but the facts are very clear. They are speaking from a subjective point of view. Mm. So you don't expect them to have made any contrary comment because they are there representing themselves, the workers, they're suffering, and they are there making all sorts of comments, and at the same time, they are still contradicting themselves. How can you say that Nigeria is not facing any problem and went ahead meeting all manner of challenges that are devilling the progress of the country? So, we should be joining with them because they've already contradicted the comments that the statement is made.
Okay.
So, generally, as regards the institution independent and that process, I want to say that, to be honest with you, even like the former president said, Nigeria has not done badly. He has the right to his own opinion. But I must say one thing, whether the truth, whether some people are saying that the country has fared well or has not fared well, they have their right to, the right to their opinion. But the truth must be told that the country, particularly as concerns the welfare of the young people, has not done well. So we, the young people, some of us are below 30, some of us are below 40. But if you look at the country, you find out that the country has not done well. The country has not given any future, any hope to the country. The country is of young people. So if you put in the effort you put in this country and some other neighboring African country, you're far ahead than you have here in Nigeria. Look at some smaller African countries that are doing very well. Look at Botswana. Do you know where they are at the moment? I don't know where we get our statistics that people have been the largest in the whole of Africa.
All right. Thank you so very much, Elekwa, for your contribution.
Thank you so much. Quite
insightful.
Can I go
ahead? Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. So I was talking about how some of these teachers at the public schools, you know, this public school environment, how they behave.
Yeah.
Now, in Nigeria, you come out and you complain that the government, government hasn't done this, the government haven't done that. Have you played your own role? Have you paid your tax? You go out there, you beat traffic light rules, you drive insanely, you destroy public properties, and you cry and complain that, Mr. President, you have not done this. You defecate on the road. You do all sorts of things, and you wonder why there are so much diseases. The thing is, we need to get our own role. Well, we need to play our own part. So when government fails, we will have the effort to say, Nigeria or Mr. President, you have failed, and we will hold you accountable.
Okay.
That's how it should be done.
All right, you continue from there, Ishoma. Kehinde, good morning.
Good morning, Mr.
Dapo. Welcome back.
Yeah, good to have you back.
Good morning, Mr. Dapo.
Yeah, we can hear you, Kehinde. Please go ahead and make your contribution.
Yeah, Mr. Dapo, I'm always been quarreling with you, but this morning I'm in your line of thought. I want to say that Nigeria is not a state, but Nigeria is not marching towards greatness as the potential carries. Because a country that is going towards greatness cannot dispose of 5,000 megawatts of electricity and having a population of over 1.7 million people. So Nigeria is put that together, and we must ensure that this country, each part of the country, has its own potential.
Yeah.
Let everybody develop its own potential so that this country can move towards greatness as it is expected. Hello, can you hear me, sir?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay.
So I am saying that Nigeria is not a great thing, but the problem at hand, both in leadership and followership, need to ensure that Nigeria moves, because the potential, we have enormous potential. We have Nigerians that are doing great outside the country, that are doing excellent, but when they come to Nigeria, things are not just working the way we expect to work. People celebrate corruption. People celebrate when new ministers now that will be appointed in a few days.
Can I ask you a question, Kehinde?
Yes, you can.
What would you do for Nigeria starting from today?
Okay, for me, I'm a lecturer in the university.
Speak up, please.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, for me, I'm a lecturer in the university, and I've made up my mind that I will do my part to contribute, to speak to young people,
okay,
to see Nigeria not in his presence, but to see beyond and look for, and let us live in this country. Personally, for me, for instance, if I'm driving and I see anybody disobeying traffic law, mm-hmm. or should the person, I'm blocking and confronting that you are not obeying the rule of the country.
Yeah.
I'm part of those that are corrupting the country. Thank you very much.
God. All right, thank you, Kehinde.
Thank you so much.
Thank
and
you,
continue
Kehinde.
The good work.
And let's just all ensure that we give back to our Nigeria. So it is not always enough to just say, what does the country have to give? I should also take a decision and say, this is what I'm giving back to our country. Let's go on a short break now. When we come back, we'll have our guest in the studio, and then we'll still be talking about the fallout of the president's speech and how to move our country, Nigeria, forward. Let's go on a short break now. All right, we are back, and it's still Crossfire with Dapo Anishoma. And this is an extension of the Independence Special. And we've been talking about very, important issues about our nation, Nigeria. And so, as for me, I believe very strongly that we have every reason to either celebrate or not to celebrate. It depends on how you're looking at it. Now, we have a guest in the studio, and it's no other person but Reverend Kehinde Babarinde. And we definitely will be talking about national issues with him. Reverend, good morning. Sorry about traffic and all of that.
Welcome, sir.
Yeah. I'm sorry to the whole world.
Anyway, quickly, because of time, we're supposed to be, taking a particular route with you on the show today, and that's asking. Now, I think enough of having to talk about the problems of Nigeria and all of that, but talking about the problems also gives us an opportunity to be able to look at possible solutions and all of that. Now, yesterday we considered a couple of problems that we think Nigeria is suffering from. One, we talked about leadership, we talked about corruption, we talked about, the current state of the Nigerian economy, we talked about insecurity and all of that. And I would have expected that some of this, the statement of the president, in his presidential, presidential independent speech yesterday would have addressed some certain areas of the Nigerian economy. But I felt that it was reactive. Ishoma is of the opinion that, that's the best we could have in this type of situation, considering so many other things. You heard the presidential speech.
Yeah. The speech actually started with acknowledging our place in the entire universe. Mm-hmm. The second is identifies our resources. The speech identified our resources. And then the speech now come out to say this is our problem. Actually, the independence speech is supposed not to be a kind of giving answer to all.
Mm.
It's to tell the whole world that we know what we are going through.
Mm-hmm.
And the speech did not leave us in vacuum that we need help. Mm. We need help. The help cannot be solved on the pages of the speech. And therefore, we could pardon the president for not solving the problem on the speech. However, one would have wished that he alluded to some visionary statement, except for calming the fears that the Almighty who created us know how to handle us. Mm. I think one would have expected some strategic statement like, I will do this, I will do this, I will do this. A listing of some plans and visionary plans. One would have expected that, but the speech gave hope without giving us the clue to how the hope will come.
No, but this it did kind of, because can I read that quickly what he said?
Read
it. Ended. He said, I would like to end my address this morning on our agenda for change. Change does not just happen. You and I and all of us must appreciate that we all have our part to play. If you want to bring change about, we must change our lawless habits, our attitude to public office and public trust. We must change our unruly behaviors in schools, hospitals, marketplaces, motor parks, and on the roads, in homes and offices. To bring about change, we must change ourselves by being law-abiding citizens. For me, I think that's something
to talk about. That is talking to the nation, not the strategy of accomplishing that. It is about you, not about what I would do. What we are saying is, you should come up with, in the power sector, we accomplish this.
Mm.
in the economy, the devaluation of Naira, we will do this. Just statements of facts will inspire confidence and hope. But if you are now externalizing, you are talking about me, what I should do, what
exactly. You are busy expecting so much from me, and you as a government, you are not telling me what you want to do for me.
Definitely, people will disagree.
Okay.
I'm not saying that the president is entirely wrong. The president is calling the consciousness of the nationhood into each of us.
Including public office holders.
You tell us what you want to do and what you are expecting from us.
I would have expected these 7 rules that he carved out with the 9 resources that he said we have and our place in the Federation. I would have also expected that by this time, I'm going to do this. By this time, this will happen. One will have expected something coming out like that. For instance, if you he told us in his inaugural speech that he's going to do a bailout.
Please give us an update on some of the things you have even done.
What next you want to do? It's not a political statement. We know him to be a man of his word. So we expect from him, and we are expecting from him, to say, on matter of electricity, we have accomplished it to this point. That will really inspire us. However, let's commend him for inspiring and encouraging us to be patriotic in our life and disposition. Babatunde from Oshogbo.
All right, let's take Babatunde's call. Babatunde, good morning.
Hello,
Babs. All right.
Please call us back.
Now let me take you through a different route now. Now we've talked about the speech of the president. Now, what exactly would you describe as the number one on the agenda of government from your angle, from your perspective? I mean, you've been around for quite a while, and I know that in every minds of Nigerians, somebody somewhere is actually thinking this area should be quickly addressed by the president. He made it very clear yesterday in his speech, saying that we have problems and we will do quick fixes. What do you think, from your own perspective, should be number one attention of government today that will at least encourage Nigerians?
For me, I want to believe that job creation.
Empowering the Nigerians.
Job creation has a way of reducing crime, reducing corruption, reducing Boko Haram, reducing kidnapping, which is not, all these things are not limited to one region.
Correct.
Very true.
All of them. Boko Haram of a thing, we have had them struck in one region or the other.
Even yesterday, they gave us an independent special.
I believe the president should ask his strategist to design his view into a plan of how Nigerians will be fully engaged. And that will also include...
Reverend, let's quickly take this call. Alex, good morning. Hello, Alex.
Good morning, Reverend Kehinde.
Good to have you on the show.
And then to my two indefatigable moderators, good morning.
Thank you very much.
Happy Independence Day celebrations.
Same to you. Nigerians are a peace-loving nation. We love long speeches. Don't go to Rashid, the house, as we call them. We don't love much of results. I believe the state we are in Nigeria now, we shouldn't be expecting a published show, the blueprint this president is going to follow. Because already the party that voted him into power has a blueprint that they will accomplish in the next 4 years. So, I don't belong to that camp of people expecting speeches, because we've received so many speeches in this country right from the time of independence.
Yes.
With minimal results. So, presently, the state we are in now, we need a pragmatic leader, and we've had that in Buhari. Mm-hmm. In fact, he's somebody with economic power, with wealth. He loves action. That Babangida that I conspired to overthrow him, they knew his pedigree, what he can do. Because he has that natural aura of accomplishment. So we should not be expecting long speeches. You see, my sister Ishoma, the question you will ask, I own Buhari one thing. I bulwark of discipline. I want to be a disciplined Nigeria. I want to reenact that war against indiscipline.
Beautiful.
Fantastic.
I want to make myself governable. If I want to criticize it, I should criticize it with fairness.
Yeah.
So in this, I'm challenging the press. Let there not be overbearing of the president.
All right.
Because I believe 1 year is not even enough to take record of what this president is out to achieve for this country.
Yes. So everyone wants to talk to you, please.
That is my take this morning.
Alex.
Have a happy deliberation.
Alex.
Everyone wants to talk
Reverend
to
Kehinde
you.
Wants to have a question for you.
No, not a question. I want to commend you for your perspective, and you are right in that.
Mm-hmm.
We are only saying that a statement of vision will also further encourage the populace.
Correct.
And that is our emphasis.
That's my position.
And your call for discipline, I give you my tongue.
Yes.
In discipline. You got 3 years.
Baba Tunde, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
Great to have you on the show, Baba Tunde. Let's take your contribution quickly.
Good morning, good morning. My own contribution, you know, was to be in the area, you know, where you have to what you want the people to the government to do for the people of Nigeria. So, can you hear me? Hello?
We can hear you.
I want the government to form a very strong institution in the area of welfare packages, especially for the vulnerable, you know, group in the society, namely the elderly, the unemployed, and the disabled. You see, no matter how responsibly we live our life, certain things are bound to happen beyond our control. Old age will come. And people that are put in a lifetime of their service for their country, in their golden year, they are not supposed to be, you know, to languish in poverty.
True.
So they must be taken care of properly. Unemployment, somebody may lose job, and when somebody loses job, if it's not properly taken care of, you understand, that person may be classed into a kind of a, you know, crime.
Right.
That's why, you know, you see the crime rate that is increasing. It's as a result of unemployment.
Yeah.
And again, the disabled. Because some people are born with disability, yes.
Yes.
But in a matter of second, at times, somebody may become disabled.
Yeah.
And those people are not supposed to be left on their own. They are supposed to be, you know, taken care of. Like, you know, call it any name. You can call it Social Security. You can call it Medicare. You can call it Medicaid. You can call it unemployment, your benefit. You can call it
disability. Thank you so much, Babatunde. Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you so very much. Now, I quickly want to say this. Because of time, we may not be able to take more questions. But, Reverend, from you, let's start from you.
All right.
What one thing do you want government to do for you? And what will you do for Nigeria as a citizen?
Now, I'll be a law-abiding citizen.
Great.
I'll be a law-abiding citizen. I want things to be done rightly and to be done in the right way.
Mm-hmm.
Great.
Not only in the right way, but doing the right thing.
Mm-hmm.
I want to also promote discipline like the government has emphasized.
Yes.
Of course, by my calling as a priest in a religion, I will encourage my heart to pray and desire that leadership will be great. And I encourage all other religions to do the same, particularly those who are priests in other religions.
So they can Shoma, what are you giving back?
Me?
Now, I'm
warring against indiscipline and also helping youth, you know, young people like I am, have a clear focus.
I'll be patriotic. And that's how far we can go on CrossFire today. We have Reverend Kehinde Babarinde. Though time won't permit us to really tap from his, you know, deep wealth of experience. But we'll be back tomorrow with another very beautiful, you know, episode of CrossFire.
Do
join us and stay out of trouble.
So, did you like what you just saw? I know you did. Mm-hmm. It's very simple. If you want to see more, just subscribe to our channel right now.